Telegraph journalist James O'Doherty just released a hit piece on me, which was more or less the same hit piece the Sydney Morning Herald did, but with dumber words because it's written by James O'Doherty. And don't worry, Lucy and Fergus from Dive Fairfax, your day of reckoning is coming, and however brutal we are to James today, you are going to cop it way, way worse. You will receive a verbal flailing for your sins. But for now, because James is such a sycophantic, awkward clod, and beating him's like beating up a dead jellyfish, he's just the same nothing that published the Friendly Geordies is Racist article in the Telegraph that we heard from the grapevine, allegedly, was on John Barilaro's command. And we tried to get him to verify whether or not that's true. We tried to get him to call up. He really wanted us to respond in text and with a deadline that was virtually a nanosecond later. And we said, no, you have to call. And so we recorded the whole thing. And just to give you an idea of what a talentless writer he is, we are airing the entire conversation. This interaction says more than dissecting the lazy crap he churns out ever could. Before we begin, rule one when a journalist rings, kids, never answer the phone yourself. Always have someone else suss out what they want to talk about. And who better to do that than my main man, Christo, aka Keegan's little brother, who's an absolute gun at getting these pathetic, quibbling attack dogs that masquerade as guard dogs to heal. Here it is.
Hang on, just let me turn it on, because I'm just going to say I'm recording again just on camera, so is it okay? You're okay with being recorded?
Sure.
Legend. Thanks so much, James. Hey, so the question I want to ask you is, what's your personal relationship with John Barilaro like?
I have a professional relationship with John Barilaro as I work as a political reporter.
Well, that's cool. So what is your professional relationship like?
I don't wish to answer questions for your video, but I was seeking to ask you questions for a story that I'm writing.
Oh, we're very excited about that story. But we just want to get one question. We just want to understand your professional relationship with John Barilaro and how he helps with your career. Like, does he give you drops? It's just like this kind of, sorry, it's a bit more than one question. It's kind of just a broad overview just to help us understand, you know?
I'm not interested in being part of your video, I'm afraid.
Oh, but come on, it's a bit of a favour. It has to be a little bit reciprocal, I'm sure you'd understand. Like your relationship with John Barilaro, maybe. Sure, that's a bit reciprocal. Maybe our relationship can be reciprocal too. You're so close to speaking to Jordan. It's very exciting. Come on, James.
Do you wish to respond to the questions that I've put to you?
Oh, Jordan will definitely respond. He's right next to me. He's raring to go. All we want to know is what your professional relationship with Deputy Premier John Barilaro is like. You know, just describe it a little. Sorry, James, it's breaking up. Can you hear me? Mr. O'Doherty, can you hear me?
Do you wish to respond to the questions that I've put to you?
Oh, absolutely. Jordan is raring to go. But we just need you to respond and just give us a little bit of an overview of what your relationship with Deputy Premier John Barilaro is. Is that all you can do? That's all we ask. Like, how often do you speak to him? Am I to take this silence as a bit of a guilty conscience, James? I don't want to put anything on you. You can deny anything. I want to give you the chance because we're not in the business of hit pieces. We're in the business of fair and professional journalism. So we're giving you the chance to answer, but I think our audience will they'll take what they can from your silence. What's your relationship with John Barilaro? It's a very simple question.
I don't think you've put any accusations to me, but I don't wish to answer questions for your video at this point in time.
But you expect Jordan to answer questions for your article?
I put questions to Jordan and asked if he wanted to respond. He said he did, so I'm asking for a response to those questions. If you don't wish to respond, that's fine.
Oh, we wish to respond. It's just seeing how interested you are in doing proper journalism. Will you subject yourself to one? Not even a hard question, just a pretty fair question, I would say. just about, I don't know, like, do you view the, what do you view the role of journalism to be? Do you think the definition of journalism is doing the Deputy Premier's bidding? I mean, I'm not accusing you of that. I think you might not think that. Is it a yes or no?
Like I said, I'm not interested in providing answers to the questions for your video.
Why aren't you interested?
Because I don't want to answer questions to your video.
Why though? That's not an answer.
Unfortunately, I have other things that I need to do.
So. Okay, I'll put you onto Jordan. I'll just say one more thing. Why do you think it's fit to ask other people questions, other journalist questions, journalists like Jordan, but you don't see it fit to subject yourself to the same level of scrutiny? Have you thought about this at all? Have you thought that you might just be being used, James? Like, that's not good, is it? You don't want to be used. You want to do journalism that really gets to power, don't you? Isn't that what journalism's for? I mean, your silence seems to suggest that to me, but I'm not. I don't want to make any. I don't want to tell you what's happening. But like, it seems to me that you're a bit confused.
Look, I'm sorry that I can't answer your question because I've actually got other things.
No. You've spent a lot of time being silent. You surely have the time. That's not an excuse, James. But I'll put you onto Jordan. Just a request. Next time you talk to John Barilaro, I'm assuming it would be probably tonight. Say hello from Jordan and Christo, and I'll put you
onto. I don't want my answers used on your video.
But they were on the record, James. You should have said that before. I'm sorry. I asked if it was okay to be recorded, and you said yes. So you really probably should have thought of that. I'm sure as a journalist, you would have had a lot of time to think about if someone would do that to you. Here's Jordan.
Well, if it isn't grown-up Stuart Little. The boy from anyway, eh? Nah, that's all right. I don't actually think you're a mouse. I think your journalism's pretty mousy, though. But what's up, dog?
I was just wondering if you had responses to the questions that I emailed through and sent to you via Twitter.
I will ask away because I forgot what they are because, let me just say, your work's pretty forgettable.
If you're not going to respond, I think that...
No, I'm going to respond. Just ask, baby. I'm here. The man, the myth. Give me a go. I want my right to reply.
Well, what is your reply to the question that I put to you?
What are the questions? I don't know. I honestly can't remember. You're a gnat. You're just like, I forgot you existed until you just texted me like, I don't know, maybe 45 minutes before you're going to get your deadline in, which is, you know, I've just got to say, such credible, fair journalism. James? Jamie? You there?
Sorry, I need to go.
Okay, so there's nothing. Wait. Jamie, I'll answer. Jamie, you there?
Ask the question.
Jamie. Jamie, I'll answer your questions. You there?
You're not giving
Jamie?
Right to reply.
Are you seriously not going to give me the right to reply here? Oh, that's just terrible. That is really poor form, mate. I've got to say, I've seen some really dog act journalists in my time, but to not even let me answer the question and to prefer to not even get on the phone in the first place. I mean, what kind of gutless wonder are you? Man up and ask me the damn questions. Are you even there?
James, we can't see the computer screen. It's broken.
How bad are you at your job? I mean, seriously, this is amazing. You can't even ask questions. Your job is to ask questions. What are they?
Well, he can't answer them either, it seems.
Yeah, I know. It seems he's forgotten. What are they, James? What are your questions?
I've seen your questions via email and via Twitter.
But we can't
look at them. Dude, I can't do it right now. We're recording this, so we've got the computer. I'm looking at my own beautiful face to stop myself from thinking about yours. What are the questions? And stop trembling while you're even saying, I've asked you. How trembly could you get? You wimp.
Bye-bye.
stay on. Oh my god. Okay, let's post-mortem. What do you think of James O'Doherty?
Oh man. I mean, I was expecting him. I gave him credit. I thought that he was the kid in Stuart Little because he looked like one. It turns out he is just the progeny of the mouse. How much of a rodent can you be? As soon as we turn on the light, tries to scuttle off into the corner. Pathetic. Having said that, though, you can call me anytime, James.
What a f***ing idiot.
Couldn't have said it better myself. Especially because he wrote at the end of the article, in a subsequent phone conversation. Well, it wasn't much of a conversation, James. You just sat on the other end cowering like the soft, overfed nothing in a suit you are. His assistant criticised this reporter. James, why are you trying to lie? You knew we were recording this conversation. He did not. He gave you right of reply. That's what you're supposed to be giving me. That is the first lie in just one paragraph that I bothered to dissect. Top reporting, Jamie. But second... Before Shanks claimed he did not have access to the questions sent by the Daily Telegraph. Second lie. I said I didn't have time to respond via text and said you had to call me, at which point your weak little chinny chin chin trembled and couldn't get a single question out, meaning you did not give me right of reply, we have you on camera not giving me right of reply, and I demand it as is my legal right. So here's what's going to happen now, champ. You're going to call me up again. I'm going to record the entire conversation again. We're going to have it at a time that suits me. You're going to ask me the questions and you're going to make the corrections in this trashy filth. If you do not, you pet Murdoch humbug, I'll be filing complaints to the Australian Press Council and you'll be dragged through the dirt harder than you currently are. So like this video if you think James is the worst journalist on earth and subscribe to this channel because the ride's about to get a hell of a lot bumpier.
Please share and comment below. Comment.